I'm Devin Pierce, and I'm a senior from Illinois. This poem is called My Friend's Under Suicide Mining. This is my transgender suicide myth, because as many times as I say, I am a boy, it's not a phase when I am not confused. This is my transgender suicide note, because I still miss Lila Alcorn's sense of fashion, the girl who felt so helpless in her parents' way of thinking that she chose to end it all and walk into fashion, leaving nothing behind but a heartbroken goodbye and a cry to action to better take care of trans youth. My brothers and sisters are dying, and I have survivor's guilt that gnaws on my tongue, plucks at my vocal cords, and deprives me of the voice that screams for someone to hear. This voice that tells me it should have been me. I should have been the one to walk into oncoming traffic or steal my dad's gun or take off a cop. And when I look at their Wikipedia pages, because that's all that's left of them, and see them buried as the name they were given at birth with their incorrect pronouns, it makes me so mad. It breaks my heart that this world could be so cruel to such a one soul. And when my best friend said goodnight, goodbye, the last time, I will never forget that pain. Because I am still alive, and they are not, dead by their own hands or beaten to a bloody pulp. I'm not sure which is worse, our hatred for ourselves or society's hatred for us. And in 2017, there were 27 candles snuffed out by others, 27 beautiful souls ripped from their bodies and sent to heaven. I'm sure nobody thought existed. In 2018, Crystal Lee was killed within 2 days, and all the articles are about her husband, who still has the guts to plead not guilty after admitting the crimes too horrible to retell. And maybe if society had killed us like flies or stuck us to that, I wouldn't be doing this. I would not be saying goodbye and hurting everyone I love. But 27 lives in 1 year is too many to bear, too many to carry on these two smaller shoulders. And maybe if I didn't have to constantly misgender myself by using the women's bathroom for fear of getting ridiculed, or worse, for using the men's, maybe if being androgynous didn't mean having a flat chest and short hair, maybe if I could wear my winged eyeliner and high heels and still pass as a man, maybe if the goal wasn't to pass as a man, but to be myself. But here we are, and nothing has changed except things have gotten worse. There is blood on the windshield of your cars, on every highway that Lila walks alone, in the bed of every parent who can sleep at night knowing they drove their child to the breaking point. And I'm so sick, sick to my stomach, sick of lying in bed, wondering if I will be next. What if I will be a part of 2018, 27, 28, 29? They predict this year will be the deadliest for transgender youth, but make no attempt to stop it. There is no lifeline, and I am drowning in the sea of my brothers and sisters' blood. This is my transgender suicide moment. I'm sorry I came out with myself, as much as you hated the very idea of my existence.